Okay. Now, audio player design in Python. Now, this is one of the more interesting things that we have. It's not a very lengthy code or something. You just need to understand what are the various components and how do we plan to go about using those components, right? So the first thing that you need to be doing is please create a folder. Download, if you don't have with you, you can just download a couple of at least four or five MP3 audio files or songs and store it in that folder. Also important is when we go to the Python, when we start writing Python codes, wo file bhi jab hum save karenge, just make sure that you save it in the same folder. So everything that we need has to be in the same folder. That is very important. Aisa hota kuch nahi hai. If I'm saving the files elsewhere, I'll have to give the path, right? Now, this let's first try and understand what exactly do we plan to do today, right? Now, just observe this. I'll go to my spider screen. Now, we did a little bit of GUI design last time, so we'll be continuing with that. Over here, what I'm going to do is, when I run this program, it is going to ask me to select a folder from where I'll include all the songs. And then you'll have a list. You'll have a music player, which will start playing the music like this. Over here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to list it out here. I'll have a simple symbol over here. I have something like a next song in the previous song thing here. And then if I want, I can stop. So this is how it is going to go. Can you all hear the audio? Right, you may not be able to hear the audio because but on your systems, when you run this application, you should be able to hear. What I'll do is I'll just try and disconnect my headphones, so hopefully you should be able to hear this audio. Yeah, because otherwise when I'm speaking, I use headphones, so that sound was not playing. Now this is my laptop speaker. Now I can go next song, I can go previous song, and so on. So we'll create an audio player, something like this, right? Okay, fine. Let's get started with this. Okay, now what we'll do is we'll first start with the initial tools. Apne ko jo tools chahiye na, we'll first get started with those and then we'll see what needs to be done. Okay, let's get started here. Now the first thing that you'll do is you'll first create a file and then we'll start by importing a lot of things. So first thing that we are going to do is we'll just create the window aur uske baad andar ek audio player ke liye hum logo ko jo dalna hai wo hum dalenge. Now observe this. See, when this application runs, this is a Tkinter, screen that I'm going to get. Over here, I need to create this window. I need three buttons. I need one image. And then this is this label which says music player. Now, if you see this list of songs over here, what happens is I'm actually going to create a list which will contain all these songs and then I'll just display that list into this over here. And then yahan se wo songs chalenge. This is what we intend to do. So pehle ek interface bana lete hain aur phir aage ki baat karenge. But for that, we are going to import a lot of stuff. Now over here, I've started by importing OS, right? This we'll see ki kaise. Once I open the directory, wo directory mein se mereko songs load karne ke liye iski zarurat padegi. Now from Tkinter, I'm importing file dialog, from Tkinter.file dialog, I'm importing as directory. So what I want is when the user starts this application, I want to ask the user which folder from which the user wants to import the songs, wo select karne mein apni madad karega. I'm importing Pygame as well. I'm importing Mutagen as well. And then Tkinter. And for displaying the image from PIL, I'm going to import image TK and image. So yahan par we'll also see how to work with images. So if you see, I have imported a lot of stuff over here. Now, apart from this, please, again, I'm going to create an object of class TK, which is going to be root, ye jo aapka frame banta hai, something similar to what we've done earlier. So we've created an object of class TK. Usko title de diya, jo bhi aap title dena chahte ho. Whatever is the size of the player that you want. Now I've gone by 600 into 400 and 10 plus 10. Now this is the distance from the left and the top. Whatever is the background color. Now I've gone with a background color of say black. Aap kuch bhi le sakte ho. Now minimum size is 800 by 400. Now it's up to us what is the size that you want. Then I'm going to create two lists. List of songs, ek list banegi baad mein, real name karke ek list banegi. Uske baad, I've declared a variable called index, which is declared globally, and I've initialized it to zero. Variable index is going to help me select the songs from the list. So list mein aapko maloom hai, whatever you store in a list, whether it's an MP3 song or whether it is integer or whether it is any data, the starting index is zero. So variable index ki madad se, I'm actually going to fetch the data from the list or I'm going to fetch the songs from the list. Isliye wo index humne zero initialize kiya hua hai. Now what you'll be doing for me is, first thing is, you have to write this entire code. But apart from this, yahan par do naye components hai, which you may not have on your system. So hum log na pehle usko install karenge. You see two things over here. There is something called as Pygame and there is something called as Mutagen. I'll just show you how to import this. You will be required to do this on your computers. Observe this, please. Please observe this carefully. Now what I'll do is, I will go to Anaconda. I don't want to go to the navigator. I'll go to the prompt. Yeah, aayega mera Anaconda prompt. See, this path will vary from system to system. So you need to write pip install say Pygame. See, when it comes to designing games or something, any of these audio visual components, then you will have to use Pygame. Now on my system I've already installed this, so when I write this it will say or requirement already satisfied. But please understand this, you will be required to write this command, you will install Pygame. Similarly, there is one more component that I need to install, pip install this Mutagen. And then see, on my computer I've already installed this. What you'll do for me is, you'll first go to your Anaconda prompt and you will install these two components. Uske baad hum aage chalenge. Please install these two things first. Ye install nahi ho raha hai, there's no ways this application is working. Okay, so I guess you've installed everything properly. So I'll just exit from over here. And now I'll go back to my code. So the two components that I needed, Pygame and Mutagen, I've got both over here. So I'll just exit this. Now what you'll do for me is, you will go to your spider screen. You will create a new file and you'll just type this much. After this, the continuation of the program, I'll not be showing you on the PPT screens. We will be going directly to Spider and then the codes would be available to you from there. Aap itna type karenge. Get the frame first. Obviously, when you execute this much, it's just going to display the screen or kuch bhi nahi hone wala hai. Itna pehle kar lenge and then we proceed. Okay, so if you added the root.main loop at the end, you should be able to see the screen where we've used background color as black. Okay, that is what is happening now. Now what I'll do is, I'll now shift to the spider screen and we'll keep writing codes wahan se, because I'll not be able to accommodate the entire code on my screens over here on the PPTs. So I'll just go to my spider screens. Okay, now what I need to do is, now just observe this. As of now, you have this screen. I need a couple of components over here. I need buttons, next song, previous song, stop music. Then I have a label over here where I've written music player. As of now, I'm not talking about this component where you can see these songs that are being listed. So that is later. And then there is that one image that heart shaped something that I put over here. So all these things, we'll first get the other components and then we'll get into the logic. Personally, I'll always advise that you get the basic application done and then you think of images and other stuff to make it more attractive. Don't focus much on that initially. Just make sure that your application is such that you can select the audio files and when needed, the audio files will start playing on their own. Ye hona chahiye. Uske baad hum dekhte hain. I'll just execute this once. You'll see what exactly happens. See. I'll select the folder. This folder is already selected, which has all the songs. Now, as soon as I select them, the audio will play. This is the initial thing. After that, I need to add some functionality. Where I click the next song, it should go to the next song. Where I click the previous song, it should go to the previous song. And then stop is where I stop the music. Right? Okay. So let's continue with this. So now the first thing that we need to do is, please, I'll just place all the components. We'll do this. You will first create this button called next button as an object of class button. Uske upar title de diya hai, next song. Then uske baad uska width diya hai, then whatever the font you want and whatever is the foreground color that you want. If you remember, for placing any component, we use these methods called place. So next button dot place. Now this is the position where I have placed that button. Similarly, I have added one more button which says previous song. I have added one more button which says stop. Right? Now, what I now need to do is I need to bind these buttons to a specific action. Now, what exactly is this? I'll talk about this once we finish typing this. Apart from all this, I've created canvas. When we designed that that colored balls wala game, we had created canvas. So, yahan par I'm creating an object of class canvas, and then I've just put an image on that. So, that that image, that heart and all that you were seeing, that is going to go on this particular on this particular canvas. So, if you want to use a specific image to be displayed on the screen, then you'll have to just download that particular image, keep it in the same folder, and then you put it like this. Over here, it will add the image as well. So what you'll do for me as of now is, you'll just add these buttons, you'll add that image. If you feel that image can create problem for you, don't put the image as of now, complete the entire application, and then you'll think about adding those images as well. I'll just increase the font size just to make it easier for you to type this code, right? Chali, itna type karenge, and then we proceed. Okay, now when we click on a button, we want to call a specific function to initiate some action on that click. So we had seen one method wherein while creating this button, the last attribute that we could have added was command is equal to whatever the name of the function. We can do that. Or the other method is this one. Now I just wanted to introduce this method, and we'll be using this in some more programs to come. Now suppose if I've created a button called next button dot bind. Now dot bind function is now going to bind that button to a function called next song, which we'll be writing shortly. Similarly, previous button pe apne click kiya, so I'm going to bind it to this function called previous song, which will then get invoked. And stop button ke liye we will be invoking this particular function called stop song. So this is how you can also bind any component to a specific unit. Yahan par humne usko function se bind kar diya hai. Going further, in one of the applications, I'm going to use the same method to bind it to an event. So it's up to you. So there are two ways in which you can actually connect a button to a function. One is either using the command function, or the second is using this bind function. I hope you guys have completed till this point, right? Okay, just one more point. When you write this button one, you can write button one, button two, button three. See, understand, there are so many different events. There's a click, there's just a mouse move over that particular button, or there can be a double click, there can be a right click. So when you write button one, button two, button three, these are the different events that can be performed with a button. When I write button one, I'm actually telling the system that my response has to be when the button is clicked. Suppose I want, if somebody is clicking a button, I want one response. Somebody say goes for right click on the same button, I want some other response. Maybe somebody just hovers the mouse pointer over that button, so I want some other response. So I can actually bind the same button to different events, right? So main kya karunga, button one pe ek function ko call kiya, button two pe dusre function ko call kiya, and so on. So aisa nahi hai that you can define only one event on a particular component. You can have so many different events that can be triggered on that button depending on what do you do. A single click pe alag, right click pe alag, double click pe alag, and so on. That is how it works. Anyways, I hope this much is done. Now we'll go back and now we'll see what needs to be done. See, I'm now going to develop this gradually. Now, please observe this, right? You'll quickly add just two lines for me. One is this label wala line. You'll just create this label, which will give you the title, music player and stuff, and then place this label. Just add this much. You're not writing anything else. Once this is done, then I'll get started with the logic wala part. Quickly, please add these two lines, the label ones. Please add these two lines. Okay, let's now get started with the logic wala part. Let's go step by step. The first thing is, whenever my application runs, I'll be first required to open a directory. I'll ask you to choose a directory from where the songs are to be loaded. So I need a function. What will happen is, as soon as this function executes, you will be asked to select a directory, and whichever directory you select, uske andar jitne bhi audio files hai. Say suppose you have, say, 5 songs you've copied in that folder. I want somebody to just copy all those files and add it to a list. Now that is what I'm going to do with my first function called the directory chooser. Now we'll write one function at a time. Now understand this. Directory chooser. In fact, I'm going to invoke just this one function in my program, and rest everything will take care of itself. Now over here, what I do is, I'm going to call this function ask directory, which I have imported here. Par. Earlier, I've imported this from tkinter.file dialog. I've imported that over here. So over here, I'm calling this function, which is going to ask you for the directory. Now, depending on what directory you have chosen, this statement will open that directory for you. So this will open the directory. Now in that directory, there might be so many different entries. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to write a simple loop, which will go to that particular directory, and it will pick up those files, and it will add it to a list called real name. So whatever is the name of the songs that you have, or the files that you have in that directory, I'm going to add it to this file called real names. So what do? For file in os.list directory. Now this directory is the one which you have chosen. So this for loop will just help us navigate through the entire directory. What do I do? If file dot ends with mp3. So as of now, I've written this code which will have only mp3 files. If you want to have different extensions, then you will have to add multiple conditions over here. If that is true, os.path, whatever is the path of that particular file, that gets added to the real directory. So what will this loop do? This loop will scan the directory, and for each file which ends with mp3, it will get added to this list called real directory, right? So I've added this over here. Now observe this. What exactly is ID3? See, when you say a file, that the song that you're trying to open is the data. But then there is something called as metadata. Now, what do you mean by metadata? Metadata ka matlab hota hai data about the data. See, understand, we just look at a file, apan usko double click karte hain, and then that song starts playing. But practically, it doesn't work like that. For the system to work, it needs some additional information about that particular file so that it can execute that file. Generally, the system would know the length of the file, the system would know the type of the file, and so on. So for me, for my system to be able to run that particular file, I need the metadata as well. That is why I'm going to use ID3. If you remember, I had imported this ID3 from mutagen. Now we have imported it for this. Right, so what it is going to do is, see, aapko jo song chahiye, that is being selected by this particular statement. But the additional information that I need for the file that has been selected, that is what is being done by this component from mutagen, which is ID3. So what I'll do is, audio is equal to ID3. Real names dot append. Real name is the list. What it will do is, it will add this file to this list called real names, and then finally, when everything is all right, I'll just add it to the list of songs. This is another list. So I'm actually creating two lists. One is called as real names, from which I'm actually going to execute that song, and then there is another list called list of songs, which is going to have the list of songs for us. So whenever I open this particular, or whenever I call this function, what it will do is it will ask you for the directory, open the directory. It will scan through the entire directory. As in when it gets a file with the extension MP3, it gets added over here. I'll get the metadata added over here. Once I get this metadata and everything, I will add it to this list called real names. Actually, the songs are going to play from this particular list called real names. And list of songs is just a list which will have the names of the songs, which later on I'll have to initialize as well. Apart from this, I'm now initializing the components. See, in my application, what I'm doing is, as soon as my application runs, the song is going to play automatically. Now, if you don't want that to happen, if you want a separate button for that, then the rest of the code that I'm going to discuss now from this function, that you can write it later. But over here, I'm just going to call this one function. It will load the file as well as play that file as well. So now I've written pygame.mixer.initialize. Now this is initializing that component from pygame, which is going to play that song. Now pygame.mixer.musicload. Now I need to load the first song. Now whatever songs I've got it in this list called list of songs. See, understand, real names is the list from where the system is going to run the file. But what my user sees on screen is list of songs. So list of songs is a list which has all the songs. When I say zero, what it will do is, in that list, whichever is the first song, it'll start, it'll load that particular file, and then it'll start playing that song. So when I call directory chooser, open the directory, load all the songs, get the metadata, and then add it to the list of songs. Initialize your player, load the first song, and play. As of now, this will not happen because I haven't called this function as yet. You'll just type this much and then we'll proceed. As of now, after typing this, if you play, nothing is going to happen. Okay, so what we'll first do is, we'll just make this application run. Hona ye chahiye that your application loads, it opens the file and it plays the song. Once that is done, then we'll add functionality to next song, previous song, stop song, and so on. So that is simple. But main is this directory chooser. If this starts working, then rest is pretty straightforward. Now observe this. I'm not interested in next song, previous song, and all this. Now over here, we've added this label. Now just observe this carefully. You'll do these things for me. You will call this function directory chooser now. Okay? Now, apart from this, what I need to do is, I need to add some data to that list box. So songs are being displayed in a list box. Now please observe this. So see, when I run this program over here, if you see the list of songs, this white border that you see is my list box. So I'm now going to create this list box, and whatever songs you have loaded in that function called directory chooser, I'll make them display in this particular list. So I'll just call that directory chooser. It'll select the songs. It will create that list. I want that list to now get displayed into this list box. So what am I going to do? Kaise karenge ye? Observe. I'll create a list box. List box, I'm creating it as an object of class list box. It has to be displayed in this frame called root, whatever the width, height, font, whatever you want. I've used foreground as gold or yellow or whatever you feel like. This is where I've created this list box. Now what happens is, when I'm placing this particular file over here in this when I'm appending this, what this function is doing is, if I have, say, in that list, I have songs 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So all the songs will get added, but they always get added in the reverse order, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So all I want is, ki aapke folder mein, whatever was the sequence of those files, I want these files to go in the same sequence in my list box. That is why what I've done here is, over here, after I've created this list box, whatever was this file called real names, I've just reversed it. You're not required to print real names, but the reason why I do it is because it just helps me understand. See, if you see in my output file, whenever I'm playing this application, it also shows me the list. It just helps me see whether things have been going on fine or not. You can remove this print real names. Then what I've done is, for items in real names, I've taken one item from real name at a time and added it to the list box. So over here, what have we done? I've called this function directory chooser. It has got all the files in this list called real names. Then I created a list. I just reverse the real names list and I've added over here. Once I do this much, when I run this program, it should open it should ask you to select a directory. When you select a directory, it should start playing the first song. This is what should happen as of now. Once this gets going, then we'll think about next song, previous song, and so on. That is pretty straightforward. Lekin agar ye nahi chal raha hai, then there's no ways. Obviously, the rest of the functions are not going to work. Just make sure that the application works. It starts playing the first song. Itna karenge. Now, once it starts working, all you need to do is you need to get the functionality to these buttons. So we'll be writing different functions. Now, this is a function, say, for a next song. When you click on next song, all I want to do is whatever is the song that is playing in that list, uske next index pe apne ko jana hai. So over here, I have again made use of two variables. Whatever was the previous index, I have incremented the value of index by one. And then what I do is Pygame mein, I'm loading that next song, the song on the next index, and then I play over here. Okay. Now, over here, why have we written this try and except? Why exception handling has been done over here? Now, suppose I have five songs in the list. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So suppose as of now, song one is playing. Then I go to next song. 2, 3, 4, 5. Suppose I am at 5. And if I still press next, now there is no song, say, at index 6. So generally what we do is, if you have five songs, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, if you press next on 5, it'll load the first song. So an exception would be generated if I try to go beyond the available indexes. So kabhi aisa ho gaya ki you are on song 5, which is song on index 5, and then you press next again, what I'll do is I'll just generate this exception index error because it is going beyond the range, and I'll reset the index to 0 and play the first song. So seedha seedha, agar aap last song pe hain aur apne next click kiya, to wo first song pe chala jayega. Something similar I've done with the previous song. Previous song mein whatever is the existing index, -1, load that particular song and play again. If you're on the first song, which is at index 0, about previous song bolte to there's nothing. So what I do is, whatever is the last song, I'll play that one. So agar first song pe hai aur previous bola, to last song pe jayega. Last song pe hai aur next bola, to first song pe jayega. Finally, I have this stop song event. When you click on this button, you will have that song will stop from playing. So this is how you can add functionality to all these buttons, and your video player will start working fine. Your audio player will start working fine, right? So this is your function for next song. This is your function for previous song. And then this is stop song. You can just complete this and hopefully your application should work fine. So this is how we will design a simple, a basic audio player in Python.